गुड इवनिंग एज ए पटलियर, टुडे विल सी द लास्ट बट वन चैप्टर दैट इज यूनिट 4, दैट इज प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ सॉलिड्स. अर्ली वी हैव सीन प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ लाइन्स एज वेल एज प्रोजेक्शन ऑफ प्लेट्स. ओके, सो व्हाट काइंड ऑफ सॉलिड्स वी आर हैविंग इन आवर सिलेबस दैट आई हैव ड्रॉन हियर, जस्ट वन बाय वन वी विल सी इट्स नॉमिनेशन. इन ऑल ऑल टुगेदर 4 डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ सॉलिड्स वी आर हैविंग. आई हैव ड्रॉन हियर, यू कैन हैव अ लुक ओवर इट. ओके, वन बाय वन will just clarify its elements. Different kinds of elements are there. These elements are narrated always in the exercise, and those will be asked during exams. So what are those elements, just we will see. 4 different kinds of solids, which are those? Initially just we will see its names. First one is prism, second one is pyramid, third one is cylinder, and last one is cone. Now just see, what is the difference between prism and pyramid? What is the difference? Just see the figure. Okay, prism is having base as well as top face. Name of the prism, whether it is a hexagonal or pentagonal, it is solely dependent upon the true shape of its base. Okay, so here I have drawn is hexagonal prism. Okay, in case of pyramid, there is only single base and it is carrying one apex. Apex is a point of intersection of all the slant edges of this pyramid. Means what? Slant edges are running from the corners of the base and those are getting concentrated at a single point, which is called as the apex. Okay, and this is the red line which is shown here, as good as the center line. Okay, it is nothing but the axis. During the observing the types of lines table, we have seen center line. Okay, here it is axis. It is passing through the center of the top face as well as center of the base. Here same, passing through the apex and center of the base. It is pentagonal pyramid. Just now I have said that the shape of that particular solid is solely dependent upon the base, of the true shape of the base. So this is pentagon. True shape is pentagon, so it's such kind of pyramid is called as pentagonal pyramid. Right from the triangular up to the hexagonal pyramid we are having in our syllabus. Similarly here is also, right from the triangular up to the hexagonal prisms we are having. Now what is the similarity? We can't say any kind of similarity, but difference in between these two solids is that in case of prism, all the lateral surfaces are rectangular in shape. On the contrary, in case of pyramid, all those lateral surfaces are isosceles triangular in shape, and that too slant in nature, and it is carrying slant edges. Lateral edges are always slant in nature in case of pyramid. On the contrary, in case of prism, all the lateral edges are vertical. Okay, so rectangular lateral surfaces prism carries, and isosceles triangular lateral surfaces the pyramid is carrying. Okay, this is the similarity. We can't say similarity, it is the difference. Okay, see here, top face, this is top face, and these are the top face corners. These are the elements of the prism. Top face edges, here base edges, these are the base edges. 6 base edges are there, base corners 1 2 3 4 5 6, as it is a hexagon. Okay, base corners, base edges, lateral surface rectangular in shape, lateral edges vertical, slant edges, slant triangular lateral surface in case of pyramid. Okay, here also the same cases are here. Now nomenclature is same, base edges, base corners 5 as it is a pentagonal pyramid, and apex. Okay, same in case of now cylinder. Very less nomenclature is there in case of cylinder, as because it is carrying circular curved lateral surface in case of cylinder, the curved lateral surface, but it is conical in nature in case of cone. Okay, all the left extreme, right extreme vertical lines, I am saying, it's not edges. We can't say it is edge, that's why it is what it is mentioned, generators. We have to generate the lines on the lateral surface which is curved in nature for the sake of our construction. Okay, we are artificially generating, means if we are dividing this circle, base circle or top face, or in case of cone, in 8 or 12 parts, then 8 or 12 generators we are generating on that surface in order to project it. Okay, that's why artificially we are generating on its lateral surface. That's why it is called a generator, not edges at all. And similarly, in case of pyramid, just like pyramid, cone is also carrying apex. Okay, and it is also, in case of cylinder, it has top face and base. And in case of cone, base only and one apex. Same. Axis is nothing but the point, vertical line which is passing through the center of the top face as well as base. This is the base circumference. This is the base circumference, circumferential edge we can say. In case of narration, the said solid, that is, it may be pyramid, it may be cone or it may be cylinder. It is going to rest on one of its circumferential base point. In this way, it will be narrated in the narration. Or in case of certain problems, it may be resting over apex also, as well as lateral, not surface, but it is generator, one of its generator. It will mention in the narration as one of its generator. Likewise, okay, here in case of prism and pyramid, in case of narration, the prism or pyramid, it may be resting on one of its base corner or base edge, or else on lateral surface, on lateral surface, on VP, vertical plane, or on horizontal plane. Case may be different in all the cases. Okay, so these are the different, four different kinds of solids. Another one solid is that tetrahedron, that we will see later on. Tetrahedron is nothing but one kind of pyramid, but it is triangular pyramid, or to be specific, it is equilateral triangular pyramid. Tetrahedron, tetra means four, means it is carrying four equilateral triangular surfaces, three as lateral and one is at its base, and one apex will be there. As good as pentagonal pyramid, it will be equilateral triangular pyramid, which is called as tetrahedron. Okay, these are the five different kinds of solids we are going to learn in this last but one topic, that is projection of solids. Projection of solids. This is all about the basic infrastructural requirement. The student must know all these things, all these elements, all these parameters. Okay, then only he can solve, he or she can solve the problems successfully. Okay, prior to this, switching towards this projection of solid, we will revive one problem of projection of planes. Yes, just simple, we will revive just, we have seen projection of planes. The difference between plane and solid is only one third parameter, which is negligible in case of plane, but it is considerable in case of solid. That is the only difference between plane and solid. Okay, in case of plane, we are considering it as two dimensional one. Okay, one problem we have solved here, just we will have a look over it. Its narration may be, I haven't written here anything, but I can narrate. Okay, you will also come to know what I want to say. Just see, this one is the square plane, and as the first figure I have drawn as a square, true shape of that plane is square, and that too it is, its one corner I have taken on my left hand, that too on vertical plane. Okay, so first angle method of position, it is prevailing in case of line, plane, as well as solid section all the time. Only first and third angle method of projection we have seen in case of orthographic projections. Rest other topics are carrying only first angle method of projection. Accordingly, now here is the square prism. Now I can narrate simply. It is a square, sorry, not prism, square plane. Square plane of 50 mm side. It is resting on one of its corner. Again, the elements of the plane, you are very much known about it. Sides of the plane, and these are the corners of the plane. Okay, so this is a square plane of 50 mm side is resting on one of its corner on vertical plane. So accordingly, on my left hand I have taken its resting corner on my left hand, that is, it is going to rest on vertical plane, that too on one of its corner, it is a plane. So initially, what I have done the true shape of that square plane, I have drawn over vertical plane without considering any kind of inclination with VP. So narration may be, it is a square plane resting on one of its corner on vertical plane. Side length is given as 50 mm. So true shape accordingly I have drawn here. Okay, the second sentence will carry the its positioning, that is its inclination with vertical plane. As it is resting on VP, its first inclination will be narrated in the second sentence. So it is inclined to VP, but such kind of problem, in this problem, inclination, that is first inclination, is not given, but because of that inclination, what is going to happen with the true shape of the plane, it is mentioned as it is square in nature, as the plane is in making inclination with VP in such a way that its front view, or it is also called as elevation, is appearing as a rhombus. Now shape has changed to rhombus. Earlier it was square, but it has become now rhombus, carrying smallest, we can say, diagonal of so and so length. That is, here it is exactly, I think it is half, that is 30 mm. Side length is 50, but in case of this fourth figure, this is the first, as it is not making inclination with VP, as entire plane is resting on VP, its top image will be line image, that too on HRL, that is horizontal reference line XY drawn here. I have written VP and HP. We should write here VP and HP so that it will be clear that we are going to solve this problem by considering first angle method of position. So as it is not making any kind of inclination, that is, it is totally resting on VP, its top view inclination, its top view will be single line, that too over HRL. Third line, third image, first image, second image, third image is carrying first inclination.